I would like to introduce now Mr. Philippe Chevalier Chantepie, who is a political advisor for the sphere of agriculture of the French delegation of the Identity Fraction, Democracy Fraction in the European Parliament. Also, I am present.
Hello. Thank you, Mr. David. I would like to thank you for this invitation of the future of European Agricultural Conference. I have been asked to speak about the impact of the strategies envisaged by the European Union, which, if maintained, will have a significant impact on European and French agriculture. We are aware that European society is increasingly asking for products that are more respectful of envy and animal welfare. That said, we must not fall into the trap of diminishing our food self-sufficiency or especially penalizing our farmers. First, let me remind you about the goals that you, under the leadership of Timmermans, hopes to achieve by 2030, as described in the Farm to Fork and the Biodiversity Strategy. From the Commission proposal, the strategy's intention set different targets: a reduction by 50% of use of chemical pesticide, a reduction of nutrient loss by at least 50% while ensuring that there is no deterioration of in-soil fertility. This will reduce the use of fertilizer by at least 20%. A reduction by 50% of the sale of antimicrobial for farmed animal and in aquaculture, reaching 25% of agricultural land under organic farming. As you know, several studies have been published in recent months on the impact of on production price and trade that these strategies could have on our agriculture. On production side, according to those studies, the farm-to-fork strategy will lead to lower production and higher price across the EU. The production will decrease by 20% in beef, 6% in milk, 21% in cereal, and 20% in oilseed. All of these sectors are vital for the French farming. On price side of the beef will increase by 58%, pork by 48%, and milk by 36%. For crop production, fruit and vegetables will increase by 15%, cereal by 12%. On the trade side, the drop in production in the EU implies a general drop in EU export. The study states that if all farm-to-fork measures are applied, the EU will be a net importer of beef and grains. From the French perspective, that will mean an important impact on export balance. In France, we currently do not yet have much research on the impact of farm-to-fork on French agriculture. It goes without saying that animal husbandry and cereal production will be strongly impacted by those strategies. A research published by COCEREAL, European Association of Trade in Cereals, estimate that cereal production will drop by 14%. If Europe has given itself the mission of being a world leader in the decarbonization of the economy, there remains an imperative need to ensure the increase in agricultural production, because demand and trade will continue to increase. We will not do it alone if we do not train a large number of countries, especially with the scenario presented. World prices would be determined by a smaller number of exporting countries, which will lead to greater volatility and expose us to a greater market risk. The vulnerability would affect the competitiveness of French and European agricultural sectors. It is imperative to respond to this problem and to protect our agriculture and our farmers from unfair global competition. It will be necessary to pretend the same standard imposed on our farmers on the product that we import. For this reason, we need reciprocity in the trade and the so-called close miroir for imported agricultural product. The idea on the paper is simple: to impose European envy and health standards on countries outside the Union wishing to export their product within the internal market. Priority claimed by Emmanuel Macron and Julien de Normandie for the French presidency of the Council of the EU. On the other hand, the debate is far from being won with the Commission and the Council, both on the principle and on the feasibility of the measure. This is not only the path considered by the Commission. The Commission believes that they can push the WTO to introduce envy requirements, especially with regard to the protection of pollinators or greenhouse gas emissions. At the moment, DG Agri and DG Trade are working on the subject. A report commissioned to the Commission by the Council and the Parliament in the context of the revision of the CMO, Common Market Organization, regulation will check this opportunity. During the negotiation of the CAP, the Commission and the Parliament plead to postpone it to June 2022, at the end of the French presidency. However, France is putting pressure on Brussels to finalize it earlier. This lead seems to rule out the idea of a specific regulation on mirror clause, which the Commission fears is contrary to the rule of WTO. Without going against the principle itself, there is a risk that such a measure could lead to the trade retaliation with third country. Nevertheless, France and Europe must raise the voice on this point. A point very important from France and all EU Mediterranean countries is the nutrition labeling system, so-called Nutri-Score. The Nutri-Score issue will be one of the qualifying points of the French government program during the semester of the presidency. During the vote on plenary, MEPS gave the green light to a mandatory and harmonized European nutrition labeling system. In France, it has been used for several years under the name of Nutri-Score, a device taken up by several countries in Western Europe. The generalization of such a display would, according to its supporter, reduce the overconsumption of highly processed food in salt, sugar, and fat. The definition of maximum consumption level of these elements would also make it possible to limit them in food products, according to the European Parliament report. The Nutri-Score could seem a good opportunity to help consumers in their choice. However, it turned out to have a negative impact on the image of certain French and Mediterranean processed food. Product could have vis-à-vis the consumer. Product generally of very high quality and hundreds of years of know-how could therefore be impacted negatively. The Minister of Agriculture, Julien de Normandie, declared that a revision of the methodology on which the system is based is necessary because it determines classification that do not necessarily conform to dietary habits. The French minister also indicated that the review must take place before the entry into force of the Nutri-Score system at the European level, because otherwise the competitiveness of the French product could be penalized. And he made an explicit reference to the cheese. According to the French cheese producer, the Nutri-Score has an unjustified punitive impact, as it's based on an algorithm that does not take into account the quantities that are generally consumed. With the statement of the French minister, the position of some member states against the Nutri-Score find the new ideas motivation to achieve the goal of providing consumer with rational information based on rigorous scientific evaluation, and at the same time protect the Mediterranean diet and all GIs. Another point very sensitive for France is protein production. It is in the tune with the time that it's even part of the farm to fork voted in plenary to want to find alternative to red meat. Alternatives that range from consuming insect to producing alternative meat to the detriment of the French and European cattle breeding. As you may know, the Commission recently authorize the consumption of certain insects. However, associated problem will be the meat production and the idea of the cultured meat. It's not specified yet in the farm to fork, but it seems it can be reality sooner than we think. As a matter of fact, last month, the European Commission has defended to move a grant of 2 million from the EU Recovery Fund to a research and development project designed to move forward in cellular agriculture and curb cost or low growth meat. Cultured meat, also known as synthetic, artificial, or in vitro meat, is a product obtained by harvesting animal muscle cells that then place in a bioreactor and fed with protein to help tissue growth. The project aims to further improve the sustainability of the cellular agriculture value chain and is funded under the REACT-EU. The Commission was informed by the Netherlands authority that the Feed for Meat project contributes to the green and digital transition on which REACT-EU focuses in Netherlands. Considering that, it provides research and development support in order to enable the scaling up of the cultured beef. The pro-cellular meat lobby supporting this technique say cellular meat farming requires fewer animals to be kept. As a result, there will be fewer emissions of greenhouse gas, such as ammonia and methane, and there will be less soil pollution. Those drift will for sure have a major impact on our French and European cattle. Another crucial point is the timing. Indeed, last week we voted for the new CAP in plenary in Strasbourg. This CAP will cover the year from 2023 to 2027. The ambition of the Commission is to make the objective of the farm to fork and the biodiversity strategies binding on this CAP. However, we know that the time is not in Commission side. Indeed, the Commission will first have to present the impact assessment next year. This will be followed by proposal for changes of the regulation, which will be presented to the Parliament and the Council. The work, which promised to be long and complex, will not begin before the end of 2022 and beginning 2023. And very likely, they will not finish before the European electoral break of 2024. This file will therefore be taken up by the new parliament at the same time of the revising of the objective of the CAP on 2025. It therefore appears that it will be very difficult to reach the objective proposed by 2030. On my conclusion, I would like to say that the action imposed by the farm to fork strategy are to be considered as one-off and not validated by a scientific basis, either with regard of the type of intervention or with regard of their scope. Finally, it seems imperative that the Commission sets up a comprehensive impact assessment in cooperation with representatives for European farmers, avoiding transforming this farm-to-fork strategy in a farm-to-fork tragedy. What is worrying is that the United States, to avoid taking dictation from the EU, has decided to launch its own productivity strategy, incorporating a coalition of several countries that aim to reconcile sustainability and productivity based on innovation. The EU proposed to reduce agricultural production when the US launches a productivity coalition. Are they preparing with their allies to recover the activity abandoned by the EU? It is the time for European decision makers to overhaul an agricultural policy able to of feeding citizens and supporting farmers. Yes, agriculture must be sustainable, but above all, it must be able to exist. Agriculture that disappears will certainly no longer pollute, but neither will it feed the French and European citizens. Thank you for your attention.
Já bych chtěl poděkovat panu Chevalierovi za jeho vystoupení.
I would like to thank Mr. Chevalier for his message and paper with crucial information proving that so-called common agriculture policy commonly influences mostly negatively agriculture in all European Union countries. And the European Union probably does not aim at increasing self-sufficiency of individual member states, but primarily sub.
Question to Mr. Chevalier. In France, there is a law on regulation on condition for business chains. In France, how is it possible to put it into practice?
Yes, thank you for the question. Yes, it's true that the government has tried to put in place this law, but for the moment there is still some problem with the different partner of the chain. So the law exists, but in the reality it doesn't work for the moment. At the European level, they tried also to do something like this with a file where the chief was Paolo De Castro. We voted in 2019-2020, and the member states have to put in their law this regulation that we voted in the parliament. We can say that the idea is good, but we still need to improve the work at the French level on this side. Thank you.
Mr. Chevalier, we know that the French know how to protest. So how will French farmers respond to the new conditions of, in agriculture?
Well, the French are the best in the protest, but for the moment, the CAP CAP reform was quite well accepted by the different agri representative, and they are still working with the ministry on their strategic plan. We know that we have less than one month to send it to the Commission, and the side on the farm to fork and the biodiversity strategy, there is not enough information for me on the field to provoke stress and stress for the farmers. So I think it's too early to start the protest or to start to raise the voice. I think the minister will do his best next 6 months with the presidency. And of course, we are waiting for the impact assessment from the Commission, a full impact assessment, because for the moment, the document that we receive are not full enough. And I think the problem will come after June next year, when the impact assessment will be published and when the first rules will be published by the Commission.